Chinatown residents sound off during a heated community meeting over the city's plans to open a homeless shelter.
CBS2's Allie Bauman reports some people fear the shelter is going to lead to a rise in hate crimes.
Furor erupts inside a public hearing in Chinatown Friday, with hundreds of residents inside and hundreds more locked out.
You are killing our people. You are killing our business. You are killing our livelihood.
The issue at hand, a homeless shelter that the city plans to open next year on East Broadway by Forsythe Street. Residents say it will be the sixth shelter in their neighborhood.
I feel not safe living in this community because I'm surrounded by shelters.
We have more shelters than anyone.
We are dealing with the same thing in Harlem. We've seen our city continuously place these facilities in communities of color while totally ignoring other communities.
The new shelter will house 120 single adults. The city says it decided to open it here after four homeless people were murdered while sleeping on the street in Chinatown in 2019.
It is critical to treat all homeless people in New York City with dignity and respect.
But over the last 2 years, the neighborhood has seen a rise in anti-Asian hate crimes. Some we've reported on have involved suspects who are homeless with a history of mental illness.
Many anti-Asian crime are committed by homeless people who are mentally disturbed. And you put another shelter here?
In the past 38 years that I lived in Chinatown, it has never felt as unsafe as now. The homelessness is a issue.
The city argues a new shelter will make the streets safer.
Making sure that New Yorkers who are experiencing homelessness on the street have a safe place to sleep inside and to be connected to programs and services.
The city says this shelter is basically a done deal and they plan to move forward with finalizing the contract. But residents tell me they will continue to fight. In Chinatown, Allie Bauman, CBS 2 News.
There's always been town hall meetings, community meetings, meetings about what goes on in certain neighborhoods. Community activists, residents in that community who are concerned about that community, they have meetings. Dave Chappelle went viral last week because he did not want, and the people of that community did not want, affordable housing a part of their community. So we see this all the time. This has been going on since politics have been implemented here in America. Period. You're going to have people who don't want to live around certain people, certain types of people. But this community meeting here is on a different level. They don't want to live around not just homeless Black people, but Black people, period. Chinese people, Asian people want to leave Chinatown, Chinatown. They don't want gentrification. That's gentrification. All over the news, there's been story after story after story after story after story of Asian men and women, particularly elders, being attacked by the homeless, Black homeless. It's been playing over and over and over and over and over in the news. What does that do to the brain? If you're shown something over and over and over and over, what does that do to the brain? When you see a particular group of people, you believe they're all like that. If you've been out, if you're not sitting in the house, worshiping content creators, and you've actually been out mingling with people at the grocery store, to and from work, you would notice that Asians are very, very salty with Black people, not just the Black homeless. The Black homeless is just a front. smoking mirror. They don't want to live around black people. I don't have a problem with that. I'm all for it. I don't want to live around no one who does not want to live around me. As a matter of fact, I'll help you protest me not living around Jazz. I'll help you protest. That's how much in favor I am of your message. But here's the problem. Where is black people's message? Where is your response? Many black people don't even know this is happening. You've allowed gentrification. You've been a part of a Democrat Party who molded you into accepting your enemies, accepting everyone. Once they get numbers on you, they turn on you. They turn on you. I don't have a problem with the Asian community not liking me as an individual. I give two fucks. My issue is the response of black people. What is your response? Because black people, for the most part, go to Asians for damn near everything they need. So how can you wage a war against people you get your food from, you pay your rent to, you buy weave from? Let's keep it a buck. Let's keep it all the way a buck. How can you wage war? How can you stand up to a group of people, a culture of people, where you get the majority of your goods, your items from, especially weave, fake hair, liquor stores? Where are the videos of Asian store owners packing up saying, we can't stay here anymore? We can't sell malt liquor to winos anymore because the community got together and kicked us out. That doesn't happen. But the Asians will get together and say, you're killing us. You're killing our livelihood. You're killing our people. I mean, that lady was angry. But you have to understand that the media is playing this over and over and over and over and over and over and over until they implant it in Asians' head that black people will rob them. It doesn't matter if you're poor or not. It doesn't matter if you're homeless or not. You will rob them. San Francisco. You've had Asians' homes broken into by black perpetrators. Period. So they're paranoid. I understand. But what's black people's response? That's the big question. Are you going to shut them down? Because listen, and what I mean by shut them down, meaning shut their business down in your gentrified neighborhood. Your gentrified neighborhood, you have all of these different cultures. Because you guys are Democrats. You pro-blacks. You pro-blacks. You're Democrats. And this is why I said, listen, I don't have time to be beefing with any Africans. I got bigger fish to fry. Black people have enemies on all sides. And your leaders have robbed you and steered you in the wrong direction. Gave you a lot of false information. Now, Asians have opened up liquor stores in the worst black communities in America. It doesn't matter if it's in Compton, Watts, South Central, East LA, Chicago, Brooklyn, Bronx. Asian people need to own up to the fact that they have risked their lives trying to go after that black dollar. Going after that black dollar. Saving up your money and building liquor stores and fried chicken spots in the worst neighborhoods you could find all over the American dollar. You have to accept some type of accountability. Now, since you're done with black people, get the F-U-C-K out of your neighborhood. They're not saying the homeless is killing us. They're saying black people are killing us. The homeless is just a front, a smoking mirror, instead of saying niggas. Asian people do not call out racism from white people. It seems like they're only focused on black Americans. I was at the grocery store. And it was this white lady I always see at the grocery store I go to. And she was talking to the cashier, who happens to be Asian. And he was just a smiling in her face. But when a black person went to his register, it went from a smile to a regular face. Asians, if you want people to take you serious, spread out the anger. A lot of Asian women are in bed with Mr. Clean, European men, so you can't really call them out. It's a conflict of interest. So because you feel like the nigga doesn't have anything, it's easy for you to call out the nigga. While white people are the one who said you were the progenitor of the Wuhan virus. Said you're the reason why the world is locked down. You guys should really be mad at Caucasians, but you're not. So I can't take your fake outrage serious either. But black people need to see this. You need to see this because times have changed. That same old black American way of thinking, that's played out. All of these cultures have come into agreement that you're the problem. And many of you are so far gone when the war hit or when you start getting attacked, it'll be too late. You'll be trying to mobilize at the last minute. These other cultures, they're already mobilizing. Niggas are the problem. Much of it has been implanted in the heads of Americans by the American media. Played over, especially while Joe Biden is in office. That's all you see on breaking news is black people, men and women. So Americans, it doesn't matter the color, even black people, they start seeing this shit. And they internalize it and they accept it and say, you know what? That's the way they are. Yep, they're violent. They're thugs. Then when they take a look at black social media, that confirms it. Yep. Black people can't talk about what the media puts out about them anymore. They took over that job. Took it over, completely took it over. But while Joe Biden is in office, he will continue to have his liberal media showcase black people attacking Asian people. It's sad because, well, it's sad because of many different reasons. But when I look at black children, and how their parents are not equipped to teach them how to identify danger when they're out on their way to school and back home. I feel really sorry for black youth. they're going into a hateful world every day and they didn't do anything. They didn't do anything. They're just on their way to school. But because of what the media is putting out, because of what black people, because I want you to pay attention. It's not just the homeless that's attacking the Asians. Look what goes on in these beauty supplies, in these nail shops. Straight chaos. Straight chaos. Flat out chaos. So they're looking at all black people like all black people are a problem. It's not just the homeless. The homeless is the smokescreen. It's the metaphor instead of saying nigga. These niggas are killing us, killing our livelihoods. We don't want to be around them. We don't even want them shopping in our stores. But wait a minute. You've risked your life for that black American dollar. You saved your money in whatever country you came from, and you went to the most violent ghettos you can find, and you put up fried chicken spots. Asian people, you got to hold this L too. You shot and killed young black people in your stores. Ice Cube did a song in the early 90s titled Black Korea. Koreans have been, and Asians have been battling black people in black neighborhoods at least since the 70s and 80s, and you never moved out. You risked your life for that black dollar. Now in 2022, you got a problem. You have to hold this L also. You got to hold this L also. Black people got to hold this L because black people aren't prepared. You don't even prepare your children for the harsh world they enter every morning. I see black children all the time with their heads down. No self-esteem. None. It's sad. They're just here. It's not their fault, but the older black people are so far gone. How can they teach the youth? The Asians are mobilizing against black people, and black people really don't have a clue. Black people are still going, listen, man, I made my own lamb fried rice. I made it better than the restaurant. I'm done purchasing Chinese food. I can make it myself now. So, okay, you got a problem? I'm going to boycott you. I'll learn how to make your food better than you. But to see this community meeting in New York, and you had the inside of the building packed, you had the outside, hundreds. They're like, oh, hell nah. You're not building no homeless shelter, but it's already built and they will house the people. They don't want gentrification. You bring the property value down. They don't want to be around you. You don't want to learn. You don't want to read. You worship image consultants, effeminate image consultants. They don't want to be around you. You can't tell you nothing. And I don't have a problem with that. The problem I do have is the response of black people. And you can't wage war against your enemies when you go to your enemies to get your items. It could be food. It could be fried chicken. It could be shrimp, fried shrimp, because black people love those Asian fried shrimps. Fried chicken, Louisiana fried chicken is big in the hood in LA. Chinese food spots in the hood. Weaves, fake eyelashes, makeup. Getting your nails done, getting your toes done. You go to the Asians for all of that stuff. While they're standing up saying, hey, when you come in here, you better have your wallet out to spend some money. If not, don't come in my neighborhood. We'll go to your neighborhood. See, this is what happens when you don't have unity and you have no leadership. You can't mobilize against anything because women run Black America, the liberal Black woman. And she's not equipped mentally or spiritually, no matter how many videos she put on social media that she's a warrior. She's big and bad and she's taking care of Black America. She's not equipped to stand up against what's coming. Why? Because she depends on what's coming. And that's her hair, that's her makeup, that's her beauty. And that's first over everything. That's before her children. The world has changed and people have changed and Black America is still the same. It's sad. You have no clue of the storm that is here. It's not coming, it's here. You're killing their business. They don't listen. They can't even make money because you're robbing them. No one wants to come inside of their business because, well, customers, because homeless Black people are asleep outside of their business. They're like, damn, you're killing our business. But you put businesses in these areas, Asians. And you've been there for decades. Now, 2022, you feel different. Because you can't use Black people. You listen, man, let's be honest. Asian entrepreneurs, businessmen, have used Black people's dysfunction to make a dollar, to send their children to college. Period. Now you got a problem. Now you're being harmed. Now the news is pushing every single day, all day. Even, listen, man, if you watch these Korean, these Asian news shows, newscasters, news outlets, that's all they talk about is Black people attacking them. So the American media is showing it and the Asian media is showing it. Of course, it's going to be implanted in their brains. That'll do it. I'm out.